We need to see that because great jammers need to be able to go at very high speed, okay? They need to be able to do this fiercely, without any doubt. And not being able to stop at high speed, that's a pretty big doubt. All right, to start with, I need to free my break leg, okay? So I need to pull the weight off of it, transfer it to my other leg. Nose, knee, toe, align. If I get that, right, my articulations are under me, I'm going to be able to have some springiness. That's the effect I want to have because I want to remain mobile, okay? So, free that leg, align yourself, and then you'll be able to pick it up. You pick it up, and you make your ankle take an angle that is perpendicular to the trajectory you're aligned in, right? If I'm going this way, I need to take a diagonal angle, right? To stop myself. A common mistake is to take an angle that is a little too soft, right? That makes us keep rolling because we're still kind of in line. It makes us do this. My knees touch at some point because I kept on rolling through my stuff. If that happens and I'm going at very high speed, my knees are together, my speed, my momentum has nowhere to go. So I'm literally just going to keep pursuing in this direction. I'll fall head first. This is not what I want, okay? I want tools that are like very capable, okay? No matter the situation I'm in. So, enlighten yourself, right? Free that leg, pick up your ankle, pew, sharp angle, and then you lower yourself, okay? I don't reach to stop, I just lower myself. And from there, just hold that ankle. You hold it to the floor, ha! And you're going to hear, if done properly, a sweet noise. It'll make da 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 da. Okay? That means that you're using friction to stop yourself, right? You don't need to have your hips shifted. It's a very minimal motion. You barely don't move. You just lower yourself and come to a full stop.